Sam said jumper punching, but the talk has been, should if anybody throws a punch, it starts at maybe a week or two, and then it goes to whether or not you get hit hard and there's ramifications afterwards. Should we get rid of the punch in football?
Yes. No, case-by-case basis.
Hodgie?
Same.
What, case-by-case?
Yep.
Fev?
Same.
OK, red card?
Yes.
Red card?
Yeah, I wouldn't mind it.
Red card coming in for all games?
Yeah, I think with especially how the game is, if you're one person down for three quarters and how fast they rotate, it can be a disadvantage. So
okay, I'll come back to you then. Who would make that decision?
Because umpire.
We have a third umpire who can't tell whether the ball hits the post.
And it can't be like our fine. It can't be like our fines, where our fines come in to try and stop things, and now you run past and give someone a bump and get a fine, or you tackle someone. Yeah. It's got to be a composed decision, and it can't get dragged out too much.
And somebody has to be off the ground for pretty much the game for it to be invoked. Okay, Fev, your thoughts?
I think no, but if it's 20 metres off the ball, maybe a red card to look into it. But not. Right.
It's a big move. I must admit, I saw Phil Cleary get sent off in a VFA grand final when the VFA was the second biggest competition. He got cleared the next week. They lost the grand final when he was off the ground.
And I think that's why it's got to be a camera who can sit back and the person's off the ground for the whole time. It's got to be a calculated decision.
Can I put this to you? Should Jeremy Cameron been sent off in that situation?
No. Not for mine. No, just behind the play incidents.
So it's got to be a punch.
If someone's going for a contest and they turn their body and collect someone, that's... Yeah, bad decision. Yeah. But someone's off the ball, you turn around and whack someone. Yes, they should be.
Fair enough. That makes a lot of sense. There you go. What do you reckon about that, lads?